Here's what you're going to do with your workflow. First off, you change your code or you edit it inside a text editor. Once you're happy and you want to see what happened, you save. Very simple. I recommend using a keyboard shortcut like these, which is Command S on a Mac or Control S on a PC. This will make your life a lot easier instead of going up to the menu and clicking one of these options. Then you swap over to your browser, you open the file if you haven't done it yet, but if it is already open, all you need to do is then click refresh to see the changes. Here, let me show you an example from start to finish. First off, I have my text editor open, and I also have my browser open. It's kind of nice to have the two open at the same time so you can see everything that's going on, but you don't have to. Inside my text editor, I've made a change. Notice that I added an H2 tag, which is going to be another heading tag, just a little bit smaller than the H1. I'll go ahead and save it, and notice here inside Atom, that little dot disappears. So now I know my file has been saved. I use the keyboard shortcut because that's a lot faster. Now I'm ready to see how this file looks. So I'll come over to Chrome, and I will press Command O to open a file. I will navigate through my computer and then find it. I've called it lesson2.html, and I'll click open. Hey, and there you go. You can see the header here, and it's the same code that's over here. That's pretty cool. So what if I make a change? What if I decide to change this exclamation point to a question mark? Because for some reason, I'm not sure. It is though, I know this is HTML. I'll save it. And then I'll come over to the browser and I'll refresh. Now I could click this refresh button here, but it's actually a lot faster to use the keyboard shortcut. So I'll hit Command R, and now there is a question mark. All right, and that's all there is to it. There are a few other ways of opening files in the browser, but this is going to be what you'll be doing for now. Later on, you'll actually learn about a few tools that can do the refreshing for you every time you save. That's pretty cool. And then there are also developer tools that will let you edit websites live without even using a text editor. You'll be learning about developer tools very soon.